When preparing a project for the first render, it's always a challenge to create the surrounding terrain and additional buildings that are not necessary parts of the project, but are needed to make realistic render images. Let's take a look at our scene. In front of the camera, there's a building that fills the whole picture. It solves half of our problem, because we don't see the horizon that's in front of the camera, it's clipped by the building. The other half of the problem is what's behind, to the left, and to the right of the camera. You may say it's not an issue as we never see what's behind us. Well, that's not quite true. In the windows of the building, we already see that to the right of the camera there should be some terrain or buildings. They're actually missing because we didn't spend time creating these additional elements. Furthermore, if we have an object in front of the camera, like this sphere, that creates a panoramic reflection. It becomes obvious that other than the building, the scene itself is empty. There are three ways to handle situations like this. First, spend a lot of hours creating the surroundings. Second, use an HDRI image instead of a physical sky, which is actually a panoramic image. But what if we like the sky already in use and we want to keep it? Here's the third way. We'll modify each surface material that's reflective. First, we turn on the environment channel. Then we link an image to this channel. This image will be reflected by every object having a reflective surface material assigned, like chrome and window glass in this case.